गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू डायमंड ग्रुप ऑफ इंस्टीट्यूशंस केसेट ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। टुडे डिस्कस द प्रीवियस कॉम्पिटिटिव क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम लिमिट्स एंड कंटिन्यूटी। सो सी द फर्स्ट प्रॉब्लम, इफ एफ ऑफ एक्स इक्वल टू एक्स साइन एक्स, इफ एक्स इज नॉट इक्वल टू जीरो, जीरो इफ एक्स इक्वल टू जीरो, देन लिमिट एक्सटेंड्स टू जीरो एफ ऑफ एक्स इक्वल टू वॉट? ऑप्शन ए वन, ऑप्शन बी जीरो, ऑप्शन सी माइनस वन, ऑप्शन डी टू। सो हियर गिवेन f of 0 if x is equal to 0 is 0. So actually we have the range of sin x is minus 1 to 1. That's why here taking sin 1 by x range is minus 1 to 1. So here we need to find out the function x into sin 1 by x. So here x multiply on both sides. What to get? Minus x is less than or equal to x into sin 1 by x is less than or equal to x. Now apply the limit x tends to 0 f of x. So limit extends to 0 minus x is less than or equal to limit extends to 0 x into sin 1 by x is less than or equal to limit extends to 0 x. So limit extends to 0 minus x or plus x value is 0. So this one is 0, this one is 0. So according to sandwich property, if this function is limit 0, this function is limit 0. If both are same, equal to this limit also same. So that's why limit extends to 0 x into sin 1 by x value is 0. So option is B. Next, limit extends to 0, x cube into cot x by 1 minus cos x equal to option A 0, option B 1, option C 2, option D minus 2. So take the given integration, given limit, limit extends to 0, x cube into cot x can be written as cos by sine, 1 minus cos x can be written as 2 sine square x by 2. So next, limit extends to 0, cos x keep as this by, here sin x is given. If the sin x by x is change to 1 because of limit extends to 0, sin x by x equal to 1. That's why this x cube can be written in denominator of this one. So 1 x is here, remaining x square is the denominator of sin square x by 2. So cos 0, if you apply the limit, cos 0 is 1, so 1 by sin x by x is 1. Next to 2 I keep as it is. Next here, which in the form of limit extends to 0 sin ax by x equal to a. Okay, now so this can be written as sin x by 2 by x whole square. So that is nothing but 1 by 2 whole square. So 1 by 2 into 1 by 4. 2 1 is 2, 2 just. So answer is 2. So option is C. Next follow. If f of 9 equal to 9, f dash of 9 equal to 4, then limit extends to 9, root f of x minus 3 by root x minus 3. Suppose if you apply next two options, option A 2, option B 4, option C minus 2, option D minus 4. If you apply the limit here, x equal to 9, if you substitute, what you get? Root f of 9 is 3, 3 minus 3 is 0, 0 by 3 minus 3 is 0. So you get the 0 by 0 form. Indeterminate form. In that case, you can apply the L'Hospital rule only. So you can apply L'Hospital rule. So limit extends to 9. Root f of x derivative is 1 by 2 root f of x into f dash of 9. According to root x derivative, what is root x derivative? Is 1 by 2 root x. So here internal function is f of x. That's why again derivative is f dash of x minus 3 derivative is 0 by root x derivative is 1 by 2 root x minus 3 derivative is 0. So next, x equal to 9 substitute 1 by 2 into root over f of 9 into f dash of 9 by 2 root 9. So already values given, f of 9 is 3, f dash of 9 is 4. Substitute here values. So 4 by root 9 by 1 by root 9. Root 9, root 9 cancel. Answer is 4. So option B. Next problem. Limit extends to 0. Cos ax minus cos bx by x square equal to option a square minus b square by 2, option b square minus a square by 2, option c a square minus b square, option d b square minus a square. First take the given limit, limit extends to 0 cos ax minus cos bx by x square. So here cos c minus cos d, apply cos c minus cos d equal to what? Minus 2 sin c plus d by 2 sin c minus d by 2. Apply this formula. So what you get here? Limit extends to 0. Minus 2 sin of a plus b by 2 into x sin of a minus b by 2 into x by x square. So in denominator x square can be written as x into x. So that's why minus 2 into limit x tends to 0 sine of a plus b by 2 into x by x into sine of a minus b by 2 into x by x. We know the condition limit x tends to 0 sin ax by x equal to a. So according to this one minus 2 into, what about here a value is a plus b by 2, here a value is a minus b by 2. So 1 2 2 cancel. So remaining minus of a plus b into a minus b is a square minus b square by 2, keep as it is. So minus multiply inside, you get b square minus a square by 2. So option is B. Otherwise alternate method, apply directly. If you apply the limit, you getting the 0 by 0. That's why you can apply L'Hospital rule. In the, if you apply the L'Hospital rule, what do you get? Limit x tends to 0. Cos ax derivative is minus sin ax into a. Next, minus cos bx derivative is sin bx minus. So minus or minus plus here, you getting b. So by x square derivative is 2x. So if you, how to write this one? This can be written as limit x tends to 0. What is the first function? Minus a into sin ax by 2x. First function. Second function, b into sin bx by 2x. Second function. So this equal to so minus a into minus a by 2 here constant, sin ax by x is a, plus here b by 2 is constant, sin bx by x is b. So finally what you get? B square by 2 minus a square by 2. Same way you get the answer. Next problem, limit x tends to 0, 1 plus x power 5 minus 1 by 1 plus x power 3 minus 1 equal to. Option A 0, option B 1, option C 5 by 3, option D minus 5 by 3. So take the given limit. So if you apply the x value 0, what you get? 1 minus 1 by 1 minus 1, that is 0 by 0, indeterminate form. In this case you can apply L'Hospital rule. So limit x tends to 0, 1 plus x power 5 derivative is 5 into 1 plus x power 4, internal derivative is 1, no need to write, minus 1 derivative is 0, by same 1 plus x whole cube derivative 3 into 1 plus x whole square, minus 1 derivative is 0. Now x value 0 substitute, what you get? 5 into 1 plus 0 power 4 by 3 into 1 plus 0 whole square. That is nothing but 5 by 3 answer. So option is C. Next follow. Limit x tends to infinity, x square into sin 1 by x minus x by 1 minus x equal to. Here x tends to infinity given, here internal function is 1 by x. So option A 0, option B 1, option C minus 1, option D 2. So you can take, put x equal to 1 by t. X equal to 1 by t. That's why t equal to what? X equal to 1 by t means t equal to 1 by x. So that's why x tends to infinity is changed to 1 by x is changed to 0. So 1 by x is changed to 0 means t limit is 0. So you can apply these values here. Limit t tends to 0. In the place of x square, substitute 1 by t square into sin. 1 by x is nothing but t minus 1 by t by 1 minus 1 by t. From the numerator, 1 by t common. So sin t by t minus 1 by, here denominator LCM is t minus 1 by t. T, t cancel. Already you know, limit x tends to 0. Limit x tends to 0 sin x by x equal to 1. So according to that, this value is 1. So 1 minus 1 by 0 minus 1. 1 minus 1 by 0 minus 1. So 0 by something is 0 only. So option A. Next problem. Limit x tends to infinity. 1 square by 1 minus x cube plus 3 by 1 plus x square plus 5 square by 1 minus x cube plus 7 by 1 plus x square plus so on. Option A minus 5 by 6. Option B minus 10 by 3. Option C 10 by 3. Option D 5 by 6. First take the given series. Limit x tends to infinity. In the numerator, what is the first series? Denominator is 1 minus x cube, 1 square, 5 square, next to 9 square, so on. Difference, base difference 4, 1 square, 5 square, 9 square, so on, by 1 minus x cube. What is the second series? 1 plus x square denominator, 3, 7, 3, 7 difference 4. So next 11, 3, 7, 11, so on. So limit extends to infinity. How to write this is summation form. Summation k equal to 1 to x. 4k minus 3 whole square by 1 minus x cube. Suppose if you take k equal to 1. K equal to 1, 1 square. K equal to 2, 8 minus 3, 5 square. K equal to 3, 12 minus 3, 9 square. So on like that. Next here, summation k equal to 1 to x. 3, 7, 11, so on. So you get, this can be written as 4k minus 1. By 1 plus x square. Next, limit extends to infinity. Summation k equal to 1 to x. How to write this one? A minus b whole square form. A square plus b square minus 2ab. That's why you are getting 16k square minus 24k plus 9 by 1 minus x cube. Plus, this one can be written as summation k equal to 1 to x into 4k minus 1 by 1 plus x square. Next, split this one. What is the first one? 16 outside, summation k square. This one minus 24 outside, summation k. Next to summation 9. Plus this one, 4 right outside, 4 into summation k. Next to minus summation. Here denominator is 1 minus x square, here denominator is 1 plus x square. So all of you know the formula. Summation n square formula, n into n plus 1, 2n plus 1 by 6. Substitute in the place of summation k square. So x into x plus 1 to x plus 1 by 6. Because of here summation k equal to 1 to x only. So that's why you are right. X into x plus 1 to x plus 1 by 6. Minus 24 into summation k. You know the formula summation n. N into n plus 1 by 2. So that's why here x into x plus 1 by 2. Plus summation 1. Summation 1 means 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus n times. That can be written as n only. So here x by 1 minus x cube. Plus 4 into, here summation k again, x into x plus 1 by 2, minus summation 1 is x, by 1 plus x square. Here 2 ones, 2 twos. Here 2 ones, 2 twelves. Here, over. Next, if x tends to infinity is given, from the numerator and denominator, highest x power is common. So here, what is the highest x power quotient? X into x into x, x cube. Here what is x cube quotient? 16 to which are 32 by 6. 32 by 6, highest quotient. Here x cube quotient is minus. So write minus. In the extends to infinity is given. In that case answer is highest x power quotient by highest x power quotient. In the numerator highest x power quotient is 16 to which are 32. In the 32 by 6. In the denominator function is 1 minus x cube. Here minus x cube quotient is minus 1, so minus 1, plus, next here, these are all are zeros only, because of 1 by x square, we terms will come, 1 by x square, 1 by x, that values are zeros only, that's why these are our values are zeros only. Next here, denominator highest power is x square, so x square quotient is 1. What about in the numerator, x into x square quotient is 2. That's why here writing plus 2. So remaining part is 0. So minus 16 by 3, this one. Minus 2 16s, 2 3s. Minus 16 by 3 plus 2. So 3 is the LCM. Minus 16 plus 6 by 3 is nothing but minus 10 by 3. So answer is B. Next, limit extends to 0. 2 power sin x. Minus 1 into ln of 1 plus sin 2x. Ln is nothing but log of 1 plus sin 2x by x into tan inverse x. So option A ln 2 log 2, option B 2 log 2, option C log 2 whole square, option D is 0. So what is the given function? First given function is limit extends to 0 2 power sin x minus 1 into log of 1 plus sin 2x by x into tan inverse x. Actually, we know the condition. Limit extends to 0. Tan inverse x by x is also 1. Tan x by x is also 1. That's why here denominator x multiply, here multiply. X multiply and divide, that means. So this value is equal to 1. Already you know that, which is in the form of a power x minus 1. So you know that already. Limit extends to 0, a power x minus 1 by x equal to log a. So that's why here in for this function 2 power sin x minus 1, divided by sin x. So divide by sin x here, multiply sin x. For the multiplication sin x, this is change to 1 if the denominator is x. So you can write sin x by x. Already here x square is given. This x square can be written as x into x. One x right here. One more term, log of 1 plus sin 2x. So log of 1 plus sin 2x. If you write by denominator is sin 2x, this is change to log of 1 plus sin x formula. Log of 1 plus x by x, limit x tends to 0. This value is also equal to 1. So that's why here what is x in the place of x here, sin 2x is given. That's why denominator is sin 2x, here multiply sin 2x. One more remaining x is there now, that x is here, divide here. So that's why this value is equal to, according to limit x tends to 0, a power x minus 1 by x equal to log a. According to that you get here log 2 into this value is 1. This value is also 1 according to this formula. Next to this value is 2 because of limit x tends to 0 sin ax by x equal to a. That's why here a value is 2. So what is the remaining? 2 into log 2. Final answer is 2 log 2. 2 log 2 is nothing but 2 ln 2. Option is B. Next problem. If limit x tends to 0 under the root of log of cos of x square plus step of modulus of a minus 1 equal to 0. This indicates greatest integer function step. Internal is mod of a minus 1 equal to 0. Then the range of a contains. Option A, closed interval 1, open interval 2. Option B, open interval 0, 2. Option C, closed interval minus 1, 1. Option D, closed to 0, open 3. So first take the given limit. So given limit value is 0. So that equal to 0 means compulsory limit extends to 0. What is internal function this one? Step of modulus of a minus 1 is 0. Generally, step x condition is n minus 1 is less than or equal to step x is less than n, then x value equal to n minus 1. That's why here this value is equal to a minus 1. What is internal function here? Step of modulus of a minus 1. That value is 0 is less than or equal to modulus of a minus 1 is less than 1 because of the step value is 0. So according to this condition, so this can be written as 0 is less than or equal to modulus of a minus 1 is less than 1. So that is nothing but clearly 0 is less than, a is less than 2. So what is option? A belongs to open interval 0, 2. Option is B. Next, if f of x equal to e power step of cot x, where step x denotes the greatest integer function, then option A, limit extends to pi by 2 plus f of x equal to 1. Option B, limit extends to pi by 2 plus f of x equal to 1 by e square. Option C, limit extends to pi by 2 minus f of x equal to 1. Option D, limit extends to pi by 2 plus f of x equal to 1 by e. So here four options is given. In the every option limit is pi by 2 minus or pi by 2 plus. You can, here given function is cot x. So here verify the with first limit is pi by 2 minus, because of pi by 2 minus is first quadrant. In the first quadrant all trigonometric functions are positive. So you can verify with minus. So limit extends to pi by 2 minus f of x equal to what? Limit extends to pi by 2 minus e power step of cot x. So this is nothing but e power. Apply here limit, limit extends to 0 cot of pi by 2 minus h. Left limit, according to left limit rule. So cot of 90 minus x is tan x. So that's why here tan h step. So if h value is 0, that is 0 only. Tan 0, 0. So power value is 0. E power 0 is 1. So clearly satisfy limit extends to pi by 2 minus f of x equal to 1. So option is C. Next follow. Limit extends to infinity 1 by e minus x by 1 plus x power x equal to. Option A, e by 1 minus e. Option B, 0. Option C, e by e power 1 minus e. Option D does not exist. So here extends to infinity is given. So if extends to infinity is given, in the internal function, from the numerator and denominator, ist x power is common and cancel. So what do you get here? 1 by e. Here x by 1 plus x. So here numerator is x only. So in the denominator is x common, x cancel. This is changed to 1 by x plus 1 denominator. So if x tends to infinity, 1 by x tends to value 0. That's why this 1 by e keep as this. So minus 1 by this one is 1 by 0 plus 1. 1 by 0 plus 1 is nothing but 1 only. So 1 by e minus 1. Power x, if x is infinitive, this power is infinitive. So 1 by e minus 1, this indicates negative value, not positive. So negative value, power infinitive. Negative value, power infinitive is 0. Suppose here positive value came, positive power infinitive is infinitive only. So here negative is given. So negative power infinitive is 0. So option B. Next problem. Limit extends to infinity. X square plus 2x minus 1 by 2x square minus 3x minus 2 power 2x plus 1 by 2x minus 1 equal to option A 0, option B infinity, option C 1 by 2, option D none of these. So first take the given limit value. So if x tends to infinity, compulsory you have to do from the numerator and denominator highest x power x square, highest x power quotient is common. Here in the internal function highest x power is x square, here also x square. So from the numerator and denominator x square is common. So what you get here, 1 plus 2 by x minus 1 by x square. In the denominator 2 minus 3 by x minus 2 by x square. In the power, highest power is x only. So x common. So 2 plus 1 by x by 2 minus 1 by x only. X common, cancel that one. Here x common. Cancel also. Next, if x tends to infinity, 1 by x tends to 0. 1 by x square also tends to 0. 1 by x value, 1 by x square value is 0. So that's why here you're getting 1 plus 0 minus 0 by 2 minus 0 minus 0 power 2 plus 0 by 2 minus 0. So this is nothing but 1 by 2 power 1. 2 by 2 is 1. 1 by 2 power is 1 is 1 by 2. So answer is C. Next problem. Let f of x equal to 1 minus tan x by 4x minus pi. X is not equal to pi by 4. X belongs to closed interval 0 comma pi by 2. F of x is continuous. F of x is continuous in the interval 0 comma pi by 2, then f of pi by 4 equal to option A minus 1 by 2, option B 1 by 2, option C 1, option D minus 1. So here given f of x function is 1 minus tan x by 4x minus pi, where x is not equal to pi by 4. Already given condition, the given function is continuous in the interval 0 to pi by 2 in the first quadrant. In the first quadrant, the given f of x function is continuous. In the first quadrant, continuous means in 0 to pi by 2, pi by 4 also there. So, at the x equal to pi by 4 also continuous. So, that's why you can take f of pi by 4 equal to limit extends to pi by 4 f of x. F of pi by 4 equal to limit extends to pi by 4 f of x. Because of, if the function is continuous, limit extends to a minus f of x equal to limit extends to a plus f of x equal to f of a. If left limit equal right limit, limit exists. If f of a, the function is continuous, if equal to. So that's why you can take f of pi by 4 equal to limit extends to pi by 4 f of x. So limit extends to pi by 4. What is f of x function here? 1 minus tan x by 4x minus pi. Suppose if you apply the x equal to pi by 4, what do you get? 1 minus tan pi by 4 by 4 into pi by 4 minus pi. So here 4, 4 cancel. That equal to 1 minus 1 by pi minus pi. You getting 0 by 0. Indeterminate form. Indeterminate form. That's why you are apply L'Hospital rule. So limit extends to pi by 4. 1 derivative is 0 minus tan x derivative is secant square x by 4 into x derivative is 1. So that's why you getting 4. This is constant is 0. Now apply the limit. X equal to pi by 4. So minus secant square pi by 4 by 4. So generally secant pi by 4 is root 2, secant 5, because of cos 45 1 by root 2, secant pi by 4 root 2. So root 2 whole square is 2. So minus 2 by 4 equal to minus 1 by 2. Answer is A, option A. Next problem, if the function f of x equal to minus x, if x is less than 1. Next, A plus cos inverse of x plus B, if 1 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 2, is differentiable at x equal to 1, is differentiable at x equal to 1, then a by b equal to option A pi plus 2 by 2, option B pi minus 2 by 2, option C minus pi minus 2 by 2, option D minus 1 minus cos inverse 2. So first take the given function f of x. So since given f of x is differentiable at x equal to 1. That's why if the function is differentiable, compulsory that is continuous. So that's why the given function f of x is continuous at x equal to 1. So continuous means left limit equal to right limit equal to a to the point. That's why you can take limit x tends to 1 minus f of x is nothing but you can take minus x equal to limit x tends to 1 plus greater than 1 function a plus cos inverse of x plus b equal to f of 1. So what do you get here? X value 1 substitute minus 1 equal to x value 1 a plus cos inverse of 1 plus b. So a bring this side, cos inverse of 1 plus b equal to minus 1 minus a. Take equation number 1. So since f of x is derivable function, if the function is differentiable, compulsory left hand derivative is equal to right hand derivative. So first calculate, this is left hand derivative LHD, RHD indicates right hand derivative. So left hand derivative, limit h tends to 0, f of 1 minus h minus f of 1 by minus h. So that equal to, already you know this formula, limit h tends to 0, f of x plus h minus f of x by h formula. Otherwise f of x minus f of a by a. So next, limit h tends to 0, f of 1 minus x minus f of 1 by minus h equal to what? Limit h tends to 0, this is nothing but minus of 1 minus x minus of minus 1 by minus h. So limit h tends to 0, here minus 1 plus 1. Next to plus 1. Plus 1 minus 1 cancel. HH cancel. The remaining is minus 1. This is left limit. Left derivative. Next right derivative. Limit h tends to 0. F of 1 plus h minus f of 1 by h. Derivative formula. Limit h tends to 0. F of x plus h minus f of x by h. So according to that. So what do you get here? Limit h tends to 0. F of 1 plus h. A plus cos inverse of 1 plus h plus b. Minus f of 1 a plus cos inverse of 1 plus b by h. Here a cancel. So suppose if you apply the h value 0, 0 by 0 minus 0. Sorry, 0 by 0 you getting. So indeterminate form. That's why apply L'Hospital rule. So here this is a constant cos inverse of 1 plus h plus b. Sorry, this is a function because of here h tends to 0. H tends to 0. Here h only function. Remaining are constants. So cos inverse x derivative is minus 1 by root 1 minus x square. Cos inverse x derivative. Apply here, what do you get here? Minus 1 by root 1 minus 1 plus h plus b whole square. This one, this is a constant, 0, no need to write. By h derivative is 1. So if now h value 0 substitute, minus 1 by root 1 minus of 1 plus b whole square. But the given function is differentiable. So left derivative equal to right derivative. So minus 1 equal to take this one. So minus cancel. Squaring on both sides, you get 1 minus of 1 plus b whole square equal to 1. So here 1 also cancel. What you get? 1 plus b square equal to 0. 1 plus b equal to 0. B equal to minus 1. This b equal to minus 1 substitute in the equation number 1. So what you get? Cos inverse of 0. Cos inverse of 0 equal to minus 1 minus a. Cos inverse of 0 means 90 degrees. Pi by 2. So pi by 2 equal to minus 1 minus a. So a equal to what? A bring this side, pi by 2 bring this side, minus 1 minus pi by 2. That is nothing but 2 is LCM, minus pi minus 2 by 2. This is a value. We want to find out a by b. So a by b is nothing but a equal to minus pi minus 2 by 2, b equal to minus 1. So minus pi minus 2 by 2 by minus 1. So minus common in the numerator. So minus of pi plus 2 by 2. So minus minus cancel, you getting pi plus 2 by 2. So answer is a. Next problem, the function f of x equal to 2x plus 1 if x belongs to q, x minus 1 whole square plus 4 if x is not belongs to q, is option A continuous nowhere, option B differentiable nowhere, option C continuous but not differentiable exactly at one point, option D differentiable and continuous only at one point and discontinuous elsewhere. So, solution. Suppose the function is continuous. What about the simplification of this function? X minus 1 whole square plus 4 equal to x minus 1 whole square, x square minus 2x plus 1 plus 4. So, final x square minus 2x plus 5. Suppose the function is continuous, you can take both functions are equal. So x square minus 2x plus 5 equal to 2x plus 1. So 2x plus 1 being this side, x square minus 4x plus 4 equal to 0. This is nothing but x minus 2 whole square. X minus 2 whole square equal to 0 means x equal to 2. So clearly the function f of x is continuous at x equal to 2 only. So the function is continuous and differentiable at x equal to 2. That means the given function is differentiable and continuous only at one point and discontinuous elsewhere. In the remaining points, discontinuous. Only at x equal to 2 only continuous. In the remaining points, discontinuous. So that's why option D is the correct answer. Differentiable and continuous only at one point and discontinuous elsewhere.